My name's Teresa Boatwright. Today I'll be teaching you the lost art of cane pole fishing. My assistant, Floyd Boatwright, is here with me today. Floyd, what are you going to teach us?
Today we're going to dig a few earthworms. I've done a few already. My hands are dirty. We're going to turn some rocks over, get some crickets, and catch a few grasshoppers, you know. We're going to fish in the small streams in the area, off the road.
Here in the Texas Hill Country.
Here in Texas Hill Country, yes ma'am. As we said earlier, we're going to be digging up earthworms, and here in this older house we have here, we have a drain. And where you have a drain on the outside, the soil is very moist, and it's a good habitat for worms. And if you take your shovel, this is not the best shovel in the world, but it will dig. You just break your dirt out of the ground like that. Little work, you know, but if it ain't working, ain't no fun. Flip it over and see if you had worms. This time around, we didn't get any worms, but we did clean the hole out a little bit, maybe some in here. Okay, there weren't any worms in this particular dig, but I have found some. I have them right here on the slab, you know. They're not really big worms, but we're fishing for smaller pan-sized fish, perch, crappie, whatever we have in the area. And these will work great. We have real small hooks. You don't need a big hook for a small pan perch.
Welcome back. Floyd is back from his worm hunt. Floyd, how did that go?
Well, we got some worms we showed earlier. We saw us get the worm, we dug them up out of the ground. And I also have some alternative baits today. Here we have just regular hot dogs you buy in a pack, get the cheap ones. And we have like American Craft single cheese, you know, and you take that. And I'm gonna show you how to prepare this while she explains to you how to assemble the cane pole.
Okay, thank you, Floyd. Okay, this is just a normal cane pole that we picked up at the local store. You don't have to always purchase one. You can use a long limb, or you can use a long piece of bamboo. It's just whatever your preference. Okay, we're gonna assemble this pole. It's just a basic two-piece cane pole. I believe it'll be a 10-foot when we get it all put together. Pieces are getting away from me here. We'll lay our hook and line right there. The pole just assembles right here in the middle. And then it's a good long 10 foot. Okay, here we have the line. We're gonna find the end of it here. It's gonna be tricky there. There we go. Get the end of it all undone there. Now with these new cane poles, they have an eye on them. So you just run the line through. Tie you a knot, secure it real good. Now you know, when I was a kid, we never had these kind of poles. We had the old-fashioned, you know, true cane poles. My grandma would have never done anything like this. I mean, the line was wrapped from here all the way up, and it was done proper, and there was none of this. But these days, this is what we have, so this is what we'll use. We're just going to make sure it's nice and secure so that we can go find us a fishing hole and hopefully get some dinner. Now that I've shown you how to tie the line on the pole, we're ready to go fishing. Floyd, how's that bait coming along?
That bait is prepared. You take the hot dog, as you see, I cut it into small pieces, and then I cut it in half. The nice thing about hot dogs is take them and separate the ones for bait from the ones you're going to give to the kids. So later on, the kids can take the cheese like this, and they can have a snack while they're fishing. They're always hungry when they get out fishing. Wrap it up and have a snack.
Floyd, you're always the prankster. Let's go fishing.
basic ideas of how to clean fish. We went out fishing, we caught some small perch and catfish. We're gonna use the pliers on the catfish to remove the skin. I'm gonna use a knife on the perch to scale them. And then we're gonna fry them. Okay, get your fish out, lay them out here again. I've done one already, I'm gonna show you how to do another one. Take your knife, come up the grain of the fish, and it'll remove the scales like this. You gotta keep your knife flat and straight so that you can get the scales off. See how I did this here, around the backbone, back fin? And then you get this right here on top, flip him over, and do the same thing again, repeat it. Just go up to the top like this, get all the scales off, down to the belly. Okay, now then that I've got the scales off, I'm gonna cut the fish from behind the gill down past his fin here. So this is all belly bones. So here we cut it right here, okay? We'll flip the fish over and repeat the same thing. We've already scaled this side already. Now we're gonna make that cut. That fin on the belly up to here. See, there's the head, it's off. And the two bottom fins. Now then, we're gonna take the fish, take our knife, we'll run right in here, and cut the fish down to the fin. Okay? We're gonna run our finger in here, take out all the intestines. You can use those intestines there to catch catfish with. Throw them in a bowl. Okay, take your knife, put your scales back out of the way for the next one. A little mud cat here. We're gonna clean him right now. I'll cut right here and around, just through the skin, like this. Very tough skin on these little buggers. There we go. And then I'm gonna get a hold of the fish.
Whatever you're perfect. I ain't bite you, okay?
And then we'll get a hold of the skin right here. And you pull the skin down. Taking the hide off. Again, you get a hold of it, pull down, get a hold, pull down. Same way, just work him down like that until you get him all the way out. There, you see it's all white meat. Take your knife, cut through the back, like that. Okay, take the head and pull it off. And you have a little catfish fillet. We will fry him whole. Put him in a bowl. And then we'll take our mess like this. Turning your bag wrong side out. The trash bag wrong side out. Over the fish scales and everything. It saves all your mess and cleanup. And that's how we clean the fish for a fish fry. Thank you.
Now that we've gotten the fish all washed up, I'll show you a simple recipe for frying the fish for your family. Okay, I've gotten my shortening in my pan, and it's heating over here, so it'll be nice and ready. In this bowl, I've got some salt and other seasonings. Use your preference. I've got a little Cajun seasoning in there and other things that my family prefers. So I'm going to mix that in with my cornmeal. You can just use your fingers. It's not a big deal. That's what you're going to have to do right now. I'm getting the fish prepared. I like to make little scores on them. That way my family kind of knows where the belly bones start, and it makes it easier to peel away once they're done. You score your fish. This is a little batter that my family likes. It's beer and mustard. So you just put it in the batter and over into the cornmeal. And I'm going to get a few of them ready before I actually put them in the pan. I think our pan will hold all of them. This one's kind of a small one. We're just going to make a little small cut right there. And we'll do the other ones. Just a small incision. I actually have the best job out of this, I think. I have the most fun. I get to catch them, and then I get to prepare them, and hopefully the family will like them and enjoy them. The assistant, he gets the messy job. He got to clean them and go through all of that. We've just about got all the perch ready. We're going to get that catfish ready, and then we'll put them in to cook. Yes, I'm a messy cooker. My fingers are nasty. But if you're not messy, it doesn't taste good, I say. On catfish, I'm going to make a couple extra slits on this skin. Just coat him real good. Actually get a lot of, I do one last toss of them. Now that we've gotten the fish battered and prepared, we're going to fry them. The fish are ready. We're going to take them, and like I said a while ago, my shortening is nice and hot. You want it nice and hot. If it's not hot, you'll basically boil those fish and then they won't be good. We just lay them in there and give them a few minutes, and then we'll turn them over. If you missed out, I had my seasonings, which was salt and some Cajun seasoning, really anything that your family likes. I added it to my cornmeal and scored my fish and rolled them in the mustard and beer batter. And then rolled them in the cornmeal, and now we're frying them. It won't take too long. We'll go ahead and turn them over. Helps the batter to stay on if you don't cook them too long on one side before you flip it. We've got that fire nice and hot. That way it's going to brown them and cook them really good. Your family will enjoy them. Okay, our fish are just almost done. When they get done, you can tell that the meat's starting to pull away from the bones, and they're getting golden brown. And they'll be nice and tasty.
Oh yeah. Yeah, it's there. They're just almost ready. A few more minutes and we'll take them out of the hot pan and put them over on a paper towel to soak up some of that excess shortening. Okay, the smaller fish are ready. I'm going to leave that catfish in for the last. You just take them and place them on the paper towel. That'll soak up the excess shortening. I know some people, you know, they think that fried fish is not that healthy, and that's right, it's not that healthy, but boy, they taste good. Just lay them on the paper towel and let them drain a bit, and you're done. Welcome back. You've seen us start from the beginning this morning with a cane pole. We assembled it. My assistant Floyd showed you how to get some worms and showed you different variations of bait that you can use. You've gone with us down to the Frio River, a beautiful place to go fishing. Caught our fish, came back. You saw how we prepared in our family. Now we're going to sit down and we're going to enjoy our fish, a little ketchup, my favorite drink, margarita with a South Texas side dish of tequila. My husband, Floyd, likes his wine with his fish and a little ketchup. Floyd, thank you for being my assistant. Thank you for 24 years of a great partnership. Everyone out there, I want you to use what you learned today. Take your family out on a beautiful day. Enjoy a great, inexpensive way to have fun, catch some food, and just enjoy each other. Now we're going to enjoy our